Okay, so one of the things that a lot of people asked for was, can you show doing summarization of a book or answering questions over a book that wouldn't normally fit into a normal context window? So that's what I'm going to do here. But then the follow-up for that was, a lot of people said, the problem is that a lot of these things the model may have been trained on, that kind of thing. So I looked around and I found this book. So this is by Tony Robbins. As you can see, I've gone and bought it. Tony Robbins has done a bunch of really cool books over the years and stuff like that. And the cool thing is, he just released this book last week, right? So there's absolutely no way that they could have trained on this book, right? We can see here that this has been released on February 13 in here. Again, so I've got this and we're going to basically put this into Google AI Studio and see what can we do. And then I'm going to compare it to the Kindle version and we'll see, okay, if it's getting things right or wrong in here. Okay, so the first thing I needed to do was convert this to a text file, obviously so that Gemini 1.5 Pro can actually run this. And you can see I've just uploaded it here and it's not hugely long in the scale of 1 million tokens. It's only 270,000 tokens in here. Still a lot more than what we would see from most models out there. And most models would have the problem of the loss in the middle as well, trying to get them to do summaries of this. All right, what I'm going to get it to do is basically go through and write a chapter by chapter summary for about 200 words. Okay, so you can see I've put a prompt here. Go through this new book by Tony Robbins and extract out the chapter names and write a summary of each chapter, approximately 200 words, that summarizes the key information and any notable parts that are in there. Help me to learn this information better and faster. Don't leave anything important out. Okay, so that's all I've put in. Let's run this and see how it goes. So it will take a little bit of time to actually go through and do this. Obviously, by putting it into a text file, we've perhaps lost some of the formatting that was in there and stuff like that. So we're relying on the model to work out, okay, what were chapters? It'll probably be able to get that, I'm guessing, maybe from the table of contents or something that was in there. All right, so it's now starting to generate this out. Now, okay, one of the first things I noticed that it's done really good is that it's actually realized that the book is not just by Tony Robbins. It's by Tony Robbins and Christopher Zook in here. So we can see, okay, we've got part one, the quest for financial freedom, and then we've got chapter one, chapter two. It's still generating out. We're now coming up onto a minute of inference for doing this, and it's still generating out content. Okay, here we are. It took just over about a minute 20 to go through and do this. So let's see, okay, what it actually got out here. Let me just space this down. Okay, so we can see chapter summaries of The Holy Grail of Investing by Tony Robbins, Christopher Zook. We didn't tell it the name. It's obviously worked that out. Okay, part one, The Quest for Financial Freedom. Chapter one, The Search for the Holy Grail. And then it's got a little bit about that. We can see that, okay, it's mentioning Ray Dalio in there. Chapter two, A Piece of the Action. Chapter three. So we've got a few sentences for each of these things in here. And it looks like it's done a good job. So let's just compare it. Okay, we can see here, let's just compare it and have a look at it to the actual book itself. All right, so looking at the actual Kindle book, we can see that, okay, it looks like it's gotten all the chapters right. And it's basically elicited some information out of those. The one thing is that it looks like part two, the chapters here are actually all interviews for this book. So it doesn't seem that it's got the interviews, although it seems to have worked out who a lot of the interviews are. So let's try running it again to just get out the interviews and basically extract those out. And let's see if we can get those to actually be really useful as well. Okay, so I've edited the prompt a little bit here. You can see I've added in, go through each of the interviews and write in point form. Actually, let's put in bullet point form there. What was discussed and helpful takeaways? All right, so I'm going to run that again. And this is one of the things that you will often find yourself doing is that you realize that, oh, okay, actually, I want the summary a little bit different. I want to play around with it, that kind of thing as we go through here. All right, so it's 16 seconds in, 17 seconds. Okay, let's just let it finish and then I'll come back to it. Okay, so this time it took a little bit longer going through this. It basically took about 90 seconds in total. So I'm just going to accept the responses there. Again, we've got something similar where we've got the chapter summaries and now we've got an interview highlights from The Holy Grail of Investing. So we've got our chapters there. We come down to part two. You can see now we've got each of the interviews and we've basically got some bullet points for what was mentioned in each of these interviews in here. So it definitely has the ability to go through this and sort of work out the different key parts for this. One of the things that I found that to be really cool also is that we can ask it to basically extract information. So let's try this. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is basically use it for sort of text extraction. So we're going to say, go through this book by Tony Robbins and extract out all the resources mentioned in the book. This includes websites, articles, books, movies, and TV shows that are mentioned or talked about. So I'm going to put a colon, come down, run it. Again, it's probably going to take, my guess, between 60 to 90 seconds to go through and do this. So it's not like it's going to be something that's super quick that you might use for a chatbot with an instant response. But if you imagine that this kind of information we need to only get once. All right, so we can see we've got a bunch of websites out. We've got some articles. Okay, so it took just over 100 seconds to basically go through and get all of these. Okay, so looking at it, it's given us a bunch of websites. I'm curious to know if they're real websites or not. It's given us a bunch of articles in here. It's also given us books. So it's obviously referring to some of Tony Robbins's other books in here and also a number of other sort of interesting books that are mentioned in here. Movies, it seems like only one movie was mentioned, and TV shows, the All In podcast. So I think that's actually a podcast. I guess I didn't ask it to extract out podcasts. So it's put the podcast under a TV show. Let me just have a look and see, are some of these actually in the book? So whygpstakes.com. Okay, it turns out that whygpstakes.com is certainly mentioned inside the book in there. Gemini has been able to extract that and extract that quite nicely out of this. Another one, just picking out randomly, why venture now? If I come across and do a search for that, sure enough, that is also mentioned in the book in there. And if we come and look, you can see I've just picked out one of these articles just randomly here. And sure enough, this is actually mentioned in here as well. So it's managed to basically extract out the resources that were mentioned throughout this book in here, which is, for me, an awesome sort of find in here. Okay, so the final one I'm going to look at is basically extracting out like a topic rather than specific things. So we know that this book mentioned a Ray Dalio from looking at the summarization. So what I'm going to ask it to do is say, go through this book by Tony Robbins and find where it talks about Ray Dalio and his strategies for investment and for life. Give me a set of notes about this. All right, let's just click run for this. This is a question and answer, almost like a RAG that we're doing now. Obviously, in this case, it's not really RAG because we're stuffing the entire book into the context window. This is one of the advantages that we have. And I'll say that this book is only 270,000 tokens long. Don't forget, we could put three books in here and then do the same thing for this. So we could have three, almost four books that were this length into this. So it radically changes the whole sort of game around this kind of thing. Let me just accept this. All right, so we can see that it's broken it down into investment strategies and life strategies. So investment strategies, so it talks about the whole concept of putting together a portfolio of 8 to 12 uncorrelated investments. It talks about dynamic asset allocation, fundamentals, and then we can see some of the things about life strategies from this as well. It's also interesting to see things like this. Additional notes, Dalio's influence on Robbins is evident throughout the book. Robbins frequently references Dalio's principles and strategies, and he credits Dalio with shaping his own approach to investing in life. So, it's pretty amazing that it's able to basically extract this out from this book. And again, we know that this book wasn't trained on. This book only came out less than a week ago. So it is actually going through the entire book each time to be able to do this. Okay, so in this final one, I've basically said, go through and design a PowerPoint for a talk and a mini course about this book and topic. Make sure to include suggestions for anything that would make the course better. So I haven't tried something like this before. I'm curious to see what it's going to come out with, but it's basically looking like it's formulating a whole sort of mini course. In some ways, I guess this is a little bit like a summarization for slides or something of what it's actually gone through. You can see that it looks like it's making a slide perhaps for each of the topics in there. And it's interesting here that it's combined chapter 5 and chapter 6 because they were basically about the same thing, or they were like part 1, part 2 of the same thing going through this. So again, this took 70 seconds. Let's just accept it, the response. And we can see that, okay, we've got a bunch of things out and it's given us like a basic set of slides that we could use to make out of this. So this just shows you what can actually be done with sort of summarization. So I know a lot of you asked about the whole sort of get it to summarize something that it doesn't know, get it to answer questions that are coming from a book or from a source like this, where it hasn't actually been pre-trained on the results beforehand. So hopefully this sort of shows you what can be done with summarization when you've got a really long context window and a very strong model like Gemini 1.5 Pro. All right, if you've got more suggestions, please put them in the comments below. I'm probably going to do a video about code and one about question answering with videos and extracting information out of videos as we go through this. And as always, if you found the video useful, please click like and subscribe, and I will talk to you in the next video. Bye for now.